delivery, what it's really all about, it's all about power, man. It's all about giving you the feeling of power. You start off as a weak character. You are destined to get people to follow you and believe in you, to take on this tyrant king. You take him on, you overthrow him. That's the halfway point in the game. And then we let you feel like what it is to be that powerful ruler, to rule that kingdom in the way that you want to rule. It's all about the feeling of power. Being the ruler of Albion isn't playing an RTS game. You are a leader. You have all your heroic abilities and all your heroic powers. They are still available to you. The difference is you now rule. We give you two new game mechanics in addition to all the other ones you have before. One I can tell you about, the other one I can't. One is judgments. And any time you can pass judgments, that's like passing a law. You can say, right, no, I want child slavery. I like child slavery. That's fine. My kingdom, that is legal. That is law. That will change the world that's outside the window. That's it. You're still going to go out and fight things. You're still going to go on quests. I think people are getting hung up on this RTS element because they think of RTSs. We don't want you to feel like you're playing an RTS game. We want you to feel like a ruler, man. You rule Albion. The second feature is, you know, a gameplay feature that is going to be a little bit different and unique. And so we've got this thing called touch, where you can reach out and touch people, and there is a context to that touch. So you're king. Someone comes to you and says, hey, great king, we require 1,000 gold because, you know, for whatever reason. You are free to stand up and use your touch mechanic, just the trigger, reach out, grab that person, throw them to the ground, drag them as they're begging for mercy into your dungeon and throw them in the dungeon. As on the journey to that, they're saying, please, please, I have a family. That is an emotional connection. That grab and touch mechanic, the ability to walk down the road with someone romantically hand in hand, to guide your child back to safety of your house, to drag someone to their ultimate doom, is an amazing emotional connection. It makes you feel so much more powerful. Another powerful thing is about the combat. But how can we redefine the combat and change combat in a radical way? But what we've done is we have put this idea that weapons, why shouldn't weapons morph and change to reflect what sort of player you are? Every time you strike with that sword, it changes that sword in a minute way. If you slay a certain sort of enemy with that weapon, the look of the weapon will change, and that can apply to swords and hammers and guns and shotguns. Why can't we have it so that if you kill innocents with that weapon, your weapon will start to drip with blood? So what we're saying is crafting and weapons is done by using those weapons. Those weapons are incredibly unique. We use things like your gamer score to modify that weapon, and then we allowed you to trade and sell your weapon online. That's pretty cool stuff, and if that weapon, as it improves, levels up and has unlocks different things, that's super cool. You can expect to see the Great Fable 3 out before the end of the year.